So we've been talking about undercover, right? This is the subtitle page, and also we can see title page. Just title, what is a thankfulness? And we can see also very beautiful picture on it. We can see the mom and her daughter. Why we just see that? We just show them family, because every little learner, they are all individual kids. They are very first community for the family. So the family member is a very important community for their lives. So, you know, also we can talk about this one too. So we have a lot of empty space. Why? Because what is a thankfulness? They can express themselves. So why don't all the teacher prepare for the color pencil and also crayon, because they love to draw a picture like this one, right? So some example, when you ask them, look at this, why I can see the mom, what they're doing right now, how they feel. So why don't you ask many questions, and right after discuss about that, right after interacting with your kid, they can draw or picture their kid, especially good character. Why don't you ask their experience, right? So like yesterday, have you helped your mom like this one? So how do you feel? So did your mom say, thank you, my daughter. Thank you, Jasmine. So when you mom said that, how do you feel? So why don't you share their experience? They can draw a picture like this one, okay? And also, this is a song in the cloud. Every individual curriculum, we also provide like a 2 or 3 song, right? So why don't you download from our Google Cloud so we can sing along. For the little learner, they love to sing along. This is like a lyrics and little poem like this one. So before listen to a song or before sing along, why don't you read together about this one, stage 3. So this is really good content for them about thankfulness. The first, I thank God for this day. This is a little bit related with the religions, but not too much focus about religion. We just share about this content, right? I thank God for this day, for the sun in the sky. Very first, thankful for the nature, right? Think about the air and wind and sky and sun and moon. Everything is very valuable, but nobody think about that, how thankful for provided everything from God, right? So we wanted to little bit emphasize about God provide for us everything, like a sun, right? For the sun in the sky. The second thing is for my mom and my dad, my family, right? Everything they feel is too obvious, right? Always mom over there, always mom take care of me, always sun over there, always water over there. So they never think about how valuable, but we emphasize you have to thankful for that. We provide everything for my piece of apple pie, right? This is very little thing. So we wanted to teach them, when you thankful for that, it's not great thing. It's not big thing, just little thing. You have to thankful for that too, like a piece of apple pie. So when you read this one, and also you can explain about the meaning of this reading, and also you can discuss about that one. So they are getting a little bit more and more into your thankful lesson, right? So this is very important for their life. Good formation habit. Have you heard formation habit? Because when they say, I'm thankful for that one, I'm thankful for that one. Thank you, mom. Thank you, daddy. Thank you, teacher. This is really good. Thank you. When they open to say that, especially the little learner, because they are very important for the critical period, right? They not other yet. For the high school, it's hard to change that. Even though middle school is hard to change that. But preschooler, kindergartner, and also primary elementary student, they can change. They are possible, right? So when they just open to say that, thank you, mom, it's really, they can formative, they are great habit, that will be great, okay? Okay, so the meaning of thankfulness is still lesson one, right? So when you look at this for the red dot, that means we have something for the teacher's resource. Why don't you check this out? This is for the, this one, the character, right? So why don't you print it from our Google Cloud, like this one? So you can nominate those coin in the shape, follow the shape. So because when they see this TV, on the TV, and also the curriculum, I think they wanted to have their individual, like images like this one, right? So you can introduce like this. Hi, I am Clony. Nice to meet you, right? So this is like their friend, right? So you can also, you can change your voice too, like this one. Hi, I am Clony. Nice to meet you. This is like a sounds like a little boy, right? And then he's gonna introduce definition of thankfulness, showing a thankful heart even for the small thing. This is a definition. So I recommend to you, why don't you memorize definition of thankfulness, right? And then for the little learner, why don't you make your own action, right? Because they can understand more deeper meaning of every single word, like a showing a thankful heart. So you can express that way how they understand about individual meaning of that one, right? The showing, like a showing, right? It's a showing a thankful heart. You can make whatever you want. I think I trust you much, much better than me, right? Showing a thankful heart. When you make action and they can follow your action, when they memorize definition, they much easier to remember because that's based on the right hemisphere. So it's related with the long-term memory without any action, right? Like showing a thankful heart, even for the small thing, even for the small thing, right? I'm not really good at making the motion, but like this one. Showing, can you follow me? Showing a thankful heart, right? A thankful heart, even for the small thing, right? That's easy to remember, relate with the long-term memory. This is our definition, so they can trace the word because it's pretty long, right? It's a thankfulness. So they can practice how to pronunciation, like a thankfulness. It's not easy, right, for the little learner. So they will practice thankfulness several times, so they will be better, okay? And then for the next one, this is, what do you think about thankfulness? Like this one. This is a little story about this one. Our good character education, we always have the story because we can show them a good example when they listen to the story. All the little learner, they always love to connect with this concept, right? Without any story, it's really difficult to explain thankfulness, honest, positive attitude, good heart. It's really difficult to that, right? This is Neil Crocodile and Crocodile Bird. This is a really famous story. So you can use our flashcard, and also you can storytelling to your kid, right? And then thank you, like this one. So you can follow this direction, always there for me. So when we show them four different pictures, this is also very related with the family, because the family is the very first community. So with this picture, why don't you share their idea, ask their idea. The first, everyone look at this, my mom cares for me. So do you have any experience when you mom cares about you? So when I see, and for almost everything, right? So every different picture, why don't you share their experience and also the teacher's experience? That will be great, right? So this is a little bit very free discussion, right? So this is when you ask them, so they can answer to you, and also your kid is going to ask you about this experience to the teacher, right? And this is a little bit substitution drill. So like, I am thankful for my mom. I am thankful for my dad. They always care for me. They always protect me. And also, they're going to change only this part, like a substitution drill. So I can change like, I am thankful for my sister. I am thankful for my friend because blah blah blah. So they also, for the substitution drill, when they right after they've been talk about this picture, so we just call like a free discussion. There's a no rule, right? But this is a little bit substitution drill, so they can change only this part, and also they can change only this part too. So they will practice several times that I suggest to you. Okay, this is they can practice like a comprehension worksheet. So we also provide like answers, so they can check this out for this one too, right? And also I can show my thankful heart. Everything is activity. Why don't you follow the direction? Every individual picture like this one. I am thankful for everything. This is a little bit different picture, right? So lesson one through lesson four, like we introduce our thankfulness. So we just share that our experience. This is a little bit more detail about this one, right? It covers lesson five to lesson eight, right? And then this one. So we have an activity like this one, right? The first, I'm gonna show you this lesson. I'm gonna show you Nick Buttigieg's story, right? So that's a really amazing guy. Right before that, so we also talking about this one too, right? And also this, so right before that, I'm struggling, suggest that one too. This one I prepare for you, all the teacher, right? For the little learner, so when we think about that material, right? Like this. I always put my Ziploc bag in here. This is really good for organize your material, right? So why don't you prepare for this board? It's a dark, very pretty dark, right? So they have this curriculum, right? They have this curriculum, and also we also provide a media file, right? But this is great already, right? But for the little learner, they need individual focusing about this one, right? So this is, they can see everything. So for the little learner, hard to focus on every individual concept of that, right? So for the little learner, you guys think about, you can provide like this one, right? But we provide a PPT file, every individual image is really high resolution. So you don't have to find through Google, you don't have to search, you don't have to do that, right? So you just print out like this, exactly same as our image, right? You don't have to find that, right? So right after explain about this one, so when you interact with your kid, why don't you using that one? So I'm going to show you how to. Have a look at this. My body is amazing. I am happy to have my body. I am thankful for my body. Sometimes, even the little kid, they are complaining themselves about their body, like this one. Mom, I'm ugly, like this one, right? They always love to compare each other, right? I'm not good looking. I'm fat. I'm short, right? My legs is too short, right? My hair is ugly, right? They are just open to say complaining about that one. So we can show them everybody is amazing, right? We are just different. We are very special, right? Look at this. When you look at, for example, you can use this word. I'm gonna introduce your friend, little boy, who is very happy to have body, right? Okay, I'm gonna show you. Hello everybody, my name is David. So you can give him any name, right? So I just put the background on it, right? I'm just stick in here, right? why don't you compare with this picture? This picture, they can show them everything, but this picture, we just show them one picture. They more focus about that, right? Okay, hello, my name is David. I want to talk about my amazing body part, right? Are you happy? Yes, right? The first, why? What is that one? Eye. How many eye do you have? 3, 4, 5, how many? Can we count together? 1 and 2. Wow, I have my eye so I can see everything, right? Without eye, I cannot see, it's so dark. So, I am thankful for my eyes, so because I can see everything, right? We just talk about every individual body part, like a ear, right? So, who can find my ear? So, actually, you can also prepare some body part in here, so they can choose themselves, right? Like this one. Hello, everyone. Wow, you guys can see many different parts of your body part, right? So, can you choose the where is the ear, right? What if they can choose the wrong one? It's okay, right? What if Jasmine choose the wrong body part? So, is it ear? Not sure. Okay, so can we compare with this picture? Everyone look at this. Is that matching with this one? Uh-oh, it's a different. So, I can give you one more chance of that one, right? So, this one. Oh, really? Really? Are you sure? So we can compare with this one. Everyone, is the same? Yes, the ears. So how many ears you have? I have 2 ears. So I have 2 ears. So I can listen to my mom singing or super singing. So I'm so happy. I'm very thankful for that. I have ears. So like a back and forth, when you show them whole general, holistic picture, and also for the interaction, for the hands-on activity, think about like a kinesthetic learning. So they can choose themselves, right? When they choose the ear, they look at this one, let them use their 5 senses. So first, they can see the 5 senses. They can see the sight, right? So they know what it is. They know what is the difference between head and ear. And then they can listen from teacher. Okay, Jasmine, can you choose the ear? Where is it, right? Listen from the teacher, right? And also they can touch it, this one. And also they can smell, but they're not gonna eat it, don't eat it, right? So let them, this activity is a very interaction with your kid. And then this is this activity for the student center. So all the time, I really emphasize all the teacher, you are the supporter. So they are very important. So why don't you give them many opportunity as much as possible? They can express that way, right? So they can choose the ear themselves and put in here, right? Let them do it themselves. They never ever forget about this one, because every activity is based on the right hemisphere relay with the long-term memory, right? So every individual body part, they can do it back and forth and interaction and the kinesthetic learning. Right after that, they remember forever. Okay, that's good. Like this one, hands-on activity. This activity, all the teacher, why don't you print it and nominate those? And then we just call the hands-on activity. Hands-on activity. When they using their body part, they remember better and they not gonna sleep, right? Okay, like this one. And then also important hands-on activity to allow them to actually touch and moving thing, right? Touch and moving thing. And also, this using their body is expressive and involved. As always, expressive and get involved themselves. They never ever forget about this topic. And also, kinesthetic learning is engaging and memorable, right? What is the kinesthetic learning? Doing things is learning, right? So when they sit very nicely, they're not gonna learn anything. They easy to sleep and get bored, not interesting. But when they move to their body part, like they are walking and jumping and putting, placing, cutting, gluing, doing things is learning. So that's very famous, famous topic for the kinesthetic learning is engaging and also memorable, right? And using this one too. So this is a little bit substitution drill. Before that one, it's like a free discussion, right? There's a no rule. So very interaction, but this is a little bit more pattern and also substitution drill too. For the reading, our program will always let them using their four different language skills. First, listening, because teachers ask them many questions so they can develop their listening skill, and then they have to answer to the teacher. Speaking, listening, speaking, and also reading and writing. So four different language skills, let them develop at the same time. How amazing, right? Okay, first, this is a reading. Everyone look at this. Who can read this one? Raise your hand. My body is amazing. So because when they read long sentence, I just put that different color because they can, when they read this one, they think about the chunks, right? It's a different, the chunks. My body is amazing. They never read, my body is amazing, right? My body is amazing. So we always put that picture on it, right? We never translate amazing in Korean. Korean, right? Korean. So we just, they feel like when they see the picture, let them connect with this word, with this picture. Amazing. Wow, this is amazing. When they feel this one too, my body is amazing. Also, they can change this amazing. Like if I'm changing this sentence, my body is beautiful, like this one. My body is awesome. So they can only change this part too. I am thankful for my body. So they can also change it. I am thankful for my eyes. So they can also repeat it, right? Take a turn, and also they can do their substitution drill too. This is theory. Reparative sentence help learners to notice the pattern of English grammar, right? We not teach the English grammar directly, but there is, they can also learn through the English grammar in here too. Substitution drill allow learners to experiment with the language and discover creatively. They also encourage the learning of other words in the same exercise set. What does that mean? Like, they can change this, my body, I, like which is purple. So this is called lexical set, like a job, clause, by part. So they can change that when you do substitution drill like this one. This is really hard for the let them setting their pattern like this one. This is the same thing, right? This is the same thing. Why don't you using this one too? This is a workshop for them too. So I'm gonna show you like a very amazing guy, like a hero, Nick Buccicci, right? So this is a little story about that one. Right before that, they can watching the video too. It's a very impressive video. Everyone look at this. And also it's the same thing because that story is really amazing story for that one, right? I just also printed for you like this one. Right? So very randomly, they can choose themselves, right? First of all, I can introduce Nick Buccicci's story before that one.